What's good, YouTube? You know it's your boy, Mal TV, back with another video. Alright, first I want to start by telling all y'all Happy New Year's. Hope y'all were safe, had a good time, alright? And it's a new year, so it's going to be the same grind, but even harder, alright? So that goes for anybody that want to do YouTube, Twitch, start your own business, any of that, alright? We got it this year, okay? Got a big year ahead of us. And I'm ready to grind, all right? So I ain't gonna act like I ain't been slacking, all right? I know it's been a while since I posted a video, but I got a special video for y'all today. I'm gonna be showing y'all the last build you're gonna need for NBA 2K21 and for 2021 until 2K22 come out, all right? But I'm gonna be showing y'all the best build. You can do anything with this build. You can play park, rec, twos, threes, and I'm gonna be showing y'all how to make it and showing y'all the best badges for it. All right, let's get it. I like her lady. Yeah. Yeah, she know that I can order us. Yeah, she know that I'll make it right back. I feel like it's fun and I just gotta tap. I did it again, man. I just gotta pack. Yeah. All right. So I've made a bunch of builds and this has been the best build that I've seen. I've experimented a lot. It's gonna be a power forward. You've probably seen this before, okay? But mine is very, very different, okay? Power forward, right-handed, gonna do 23. Because this build is really a lot like LeBron James, not gonna lie. But what we're gonna do, 6'7", you already know, all right? And we're gonna put the weight all the way down because strength does not really matter in this game or really at all. You know, maybe if you're a big man, but we're gonna be handling the ball a lot. So we're gonna go 2'11 for the weight. Wanna have that fast speed. And for the arms, we're gonna go with 6'11", okay? And the reason we're going with 6'11 is because at 6'11", you get a 93 pointer. If you go up, you get 89. And when you're at 6'11", once you hit 99, you can get Deep Shots Hall of Fame, all right? Now, if you want to start off with Deep Shots Hall of Fame, you can put your arms down to 6'8", but I want to have my arms up, start getting a passing lane, you know, get steals and everything like that. So we're going to go with, I'm not going to lie, I'm going to go with slight. I've been going with burly for a lot of my players, but I kind of just like how it looks when they're like slight and it just, or compact. It just makes them look like they have longer arms, all right? So we're going to go with that. That don't really matter, though. You know, it don't change the gameplay. And here, we're going to go with an 80 driving layup. That's all you need. Going to max the dunk out. I'm going to get a 65 stand dunk. You can still get all the stand dunk animations with a 65, okay? So we're going to get 7 badges. And I'm going to show y'all, you know, you don't need that many finishing badges on here. You really only need posterizers to get posters, all right? Because you can get contact dunks without any badges. But this has just helped a lot. So we're going to max the 3, max the mid-range, and we're going to go all the way up till we get 20 shooting badges, okay? 20 shooting badges is way more than you need, you feel me? All right, but we got the extra because I like to shoot, so I want to have, you know, those extra badges. So we're going to max out the ball handle, max out speed ball, and we're going to do it a little bit different than what everybody's doing, okay? We're going to put our pass accuracy up to 83, all right? And the reason we're doing this is because we want Bullet Passer Hall of Fame. Because a lot of people have gold Bullet Passer when they're using this build and you're playing PG and your dude just throws slow passes, even though it's on gold. I find a lot of times my other build I have like this has gold Bullet Passer. And he just does a lot of one-handed passes and it's just slow. But with Bullet Passer, I have it on my point guard that I don't use anymore. But it just gets the ball to him fast. So you want your teammates better get that shot off, you know, and just make it easier to get the ball to your teammates, not get it stolen, anything like that, all right? So for the defense, we're gonna max out our perimeter, of course. We're gonna put our steal up until we get Pickpocket Hall of Fame. And then I'm going to put my block all the way up. I'm gonna put my offensive rebound up all the way to 91. And then, let me change this actually. On my last build, I had the steal on a 90 because I got more badge points by just putting my rebound down until I got to 20 badges for defense, okay? And we're not really gonna be getting boards like that because we're playing a guard position, but you still can get the boards because you have an 84 defensive rebound. So it'll really work out. And then for this, we're gonna max our speed out. We're gonna put our acceleration up to 70, okay? And I'm telling you, when you have quick first step Hall of Fame, which we're gonna get on this build as soon as we start, you don't really need acceleration like that, all right? Because I've watched the videos, they have people that have been testing it out, and you actually get a better boost with quick first step Hall of Fame when your acceleration is lower. So 70 is a pretty much like a sweet spot for it, you know, because acceleration is really just when you're dribbling the ball, you know? I don't really make sense to me, but that's how it is. And if you have quick first step Hall of Fame, you're still gonna move just as fast, if not maybe a little bit faster, because the badge just kicks in more, okay? Now, for the vertical, we only need a 70 to get all our contact dunks, and we're still gonna boom on people, okay? And for our stamina, we're gonna go to 81, all right? And the reason I'm going with 81 stamina is because, again, a lot of people have been testing all these things out, and you don't really need max stamina, okay? Because you can play a park game and have 81 stamina, and you'll never blink red, even if you are handling the ball. Now, if you're not handling the ball, you can really get like a 50 stamina. Some people have been tooling 25, but to be safe, we're gonna do 81. And this is the build right here. You know, if you wanna pause the video, screenshot it, this is it right here. We're gonna have 7, 20, 24, and 20, okay? And they have some builds that are gonna get more badges than this, but like I said, they have low steal. They're not gonna be able to get in the passing lanes like us, not gonna be able to get on-ball steals like us. And we have Hall of Fame Interceptor and Pickpocket. Like, come on, bro. Stop playing, bro. All right, and we got Bullet Pass at Hall of Fame. That's gonna help a lot. And those extra playmaking badges, you can get everything you need. You have enough shooting. You can dunk on people. And you can clamp up with twos, threes, whatever. You can guard anybody, okay? So, for the takeover, I messed up and I put ankle breaking shots on my other dude. But for this dude, I'm gonna start off with pull up precision because I like to fade a lot and they're really cheese OP and I can do it really easily. And I'm gonna put limitless range because I'm gonna be fading. So a spot up would be good if you're shooting standing still shots, but I'm gonna be trying to be fading a lot because I like to play twos. And you need a limitless range for that so you can take fades from half court, you know. But if not, you can put on negative impact, that works too. But I like to take deep fades, all right? So we're going with pull up precision, limitless range, all right? And you see, we have built an offensive threat, okay? A lot of people have scoring machines, two-way scoring machines. This build is gonna be an offensive threat. So people are gonna think that you don't have steal, don't have defense, because most of those builds that have like 80 badges, they're offensive threats and they don't have steal. But people aren't gonna know. So this is going to be a comp build, bro, I'm telling you. All right, so here we go with the badges, okay? I'm gonna show y'all the best badges for this build and in the game right now, from my experience, and just test them out, okay? So for finishing, you wanna do Posterizer Hall of Fame. And like I said, it's all you really need, but Slither Finisher on goal helps you get a little bit more contact dunk. It makes you get more room to go up and be able to dunk on people. If that makes sense to y'all, I'm telling y'all, try it yourself, it works. You can put on anything else you want, but that's what I like to do. I'm gonna start with Deep Threes Hall of Fame, because like I said, once you hit 99, get Deep Threes Hall of Fame. So this is gonna be once you get 99, okay? So we're gonna put Blinders Hall of Fame, that's a must. You know, it works how Deadeye is, but even better to where you don't even need to use Deadeye, okay? So you need Hot Shot Hall of Fame because you wanna do the special delivery hot shot method and just get your takeover fast whenever you're playing. We're gonna go Hot Zone Hunter Hall of Fame. We're gonna go Antifreeze on bronze because, like I said, I've been watching a lot of videos, doing a lot of research, and if you had this on bronze, it takes you like 3 or 4 contested shots to actually get cold or like lose your badge, okay? So you only need it on bronze. Anything else is overkill. I am gonna start using Stop and Pop because how the badge works, it says boost shot rating on standstill 3 points after dribbling. And from the research I've been doing, whenever you do stuff like that little curry slide, that counts as Stop and Pop, okay? And they have Rhythm Shooter, which is increase the chance of a made shot after sizing up your opponent with dribble moves, okay? So the difference between these two is that this one is going to be when you're doing like 2 dribble moves and then you try and shoot it. This is actually do like 1 dribble move and you just shoot. So whenever you're hitting people with that curry slide, it'll give you a boost, which a lot of people like to combo with and finish it off with. So we're gonna run that on silver. And our last badge, we're gonna put on Clutch Shooter to get a little bit more made shots whenever it's like 20 or 20 to 21 in park games and even in the rec, okay? So that's it for our shooting badges. For playmaking, we have 24. And this is pretty simple. We're gonna max out Bullet Passer, max out Handle for Days, max out Quick First Step, max out Special Delivery if you're running with somebody who's running Hot Shot. Ankle Breaker up, we wanna be able to get as many open shots as possible and be able to get separation from our defender. Bailout on silver, because this is all you need to be able to pass out of your shots and not have it just go out of bounds and go crazy. You know, like 90% of the time, it's not going to be a bad pass. So I like to run it on silver, and unpluckable on gold because I'm gonna be honest with y'all. Even if you have it on Hall of Fame, you're still gonna get ripped, okay? it's really just like, okay, you want to put on Hall of Fame, have that little extra, you know, feel good about it. But I think gold is pretty good because you shouldn't be dribbling front of defender in the first place anyway. So that's it for the playmaking. And for the defense, we're going to go Clamps, Hall of Fame, Chase Down on bronze, because I've tried it on Hall of Fame and it's the same. Sometimes the badge really works well, sometimes it doesn't, okay? So I put it on bronze just to get the animations. That's all you need. I'm going to put Interceptor on silver for now. Pickpocket, Hall of Fame, of course, because you want to get those easy steals and those bump steals. Rim Protect the Hall of Fame because you don't want to get dunked on. I run Ankle Braces on bronze because, again, if I put Ankle Braces on Hall of Fame, I still get cracked. And with bronze, I don't really feel like I get cracked that much. And it's really not too much of a difference for me because I like to bump people. I don't like to let them get them space anyway on defense. We're going to put Taj Defender on silver because everybody can dribble, okay? So you're going to be chasing people around the court, you know, just the whole time. And if you run out of energy, they can get that stupid blow by. So we're going to run this so we never run out of energy and we can always keep up with the offensive player. And then for the last two, we're going to go with Pogo Stick on bronze because it does work on bronze just for that. And we're going to go with Interceptor on gold. So you can get all those passes in the passing lane. You can get all those on-ball steals. And you just want to be able to clamp your defender and get all the opportunities to get the ball back that you can. Okay? So that's it for the badges on this build. Okay? Try it out. I promise it's going to be fun using this build, okay? Because you can clamp people, get steals, dunk on them, shoot, and you can crack the ankles with all these playmaking badges. So people are gonna love playing with you. You can run a 1-3, okay, 1-4 in rec. Okay, so try this out. It's been your boy Mal TV. All right, thank you for tuning in, and I'm gonna catch y'all in the next video.